Hi there, welcome back. Let me start with a question, a simple question. Alright? What is a constant? Answer the question. What is a constant? You know, natural answer is a constant is something where the value remains same throughout the program. It cannot be changed. That's what a constant is. Definitely, whenever we talk about a constant, we say that. We say it's a constant is something where the value cannot change. Throughout the program, it will remain the same. But problem is, while answering this in an interview, I have seen it across many interviews. I have seen when they ask this question, they say, what are the types of constant? A very common question. What is a constant? You know, the answer is a simple one. What are the types of constant? We start answering saying, sir, integer constant, character constant, you know, string constant, float constant, double constant. No. You know, the moment I start answering like this, it's a big mistake which I'm doing. Let me tell you, you know, why I have taken this up. Because I've seen there is a lot of confusion when it comes to answering this particular question. What are the different types of constants? Okay, let's start with categories first, then we get into types, because first it is categories, then it's types. Remember this. All right so what I'll do is, in this particular session, I'll walk you through that entire thing. What is a constant? What are the different types of constants or categories of constants? And under that, what are the various constants? With example, let's understand that. But first of all, let's again, you know, go back to this question which I asked you just now. What are the types of constants, or so to say, categories of constants? Well, this question has a very simple answer. When you answer this question, you say primary and secondary. Okay, what you will say? You will say primary and secondary. Those are the two types of constants. All right have a look at the first slide itself, where I have put up categories of constants, and under that, what are the various types. Got it? Have a look. Well, I have put them into two different categories, primary and secondary. If you look at the primary one, what you find over there? Under primary, you have what? You have integer constants, you have real constants, and you have character constants. Under secondary, you have arrays, you have pointers, you have structures, you have unions, and you have something called enumerators, or so to say, enum. Okay? Clear with this? Okay? Let's get back now. So you got it? You call it either primary, you call it either primary. Or you call it secondary. Now see, the diagram which I have shown you there, when you looked at it, what you found? Under primary, what are the different ones? You know, integer constants, character constants, real constants. These are, if you relate them, what you'll find? Those are data types, the primary data types which you have. You know, as many data types, that many types of constants. Very simple. Alright. So, what happens here? If I am talking about primary, why I call it primary? Because they are from the basic data types. Got it? And why I call them secondary? Because, you know, they are derived. They are created after we have the primary data types. Got it? Clear? Okay. So, now, let's start with the definition, and then we get into the details. Here is the definition for you. Look at the slide. You know, just sometimes we could discuss this. Clear? Constant is a value that cannot be changed. This is what I told you just now. Exactly, this is what I told you. And if I look at categories, primary, under primary you have integer, float and character. Secondary, you have array, structure, pointer, enum. This we have already seen in that diagram. Okay, clear? Okay, now coming back to primary constants. As I told you, primary constants, we looked at integer, we looked at character, we looked at real, these three. But you know, I can simply put them into two different categories, saying one is numeric, primary constants I'm talking about. I can say numeric. I can say character, because character is something else altogether, right? Something else altogether. All right. So I'll say numeric. Why I say numeric? Because it consists of numbers. Very simple. Have a look at this particular division. Okay. From here we move into the types, different types. All right. Have a look. Look at that. Primary constants, numeric. Under numeric we have put integer and real. Under character we have put character constants and multiple character constants, which is also known as a string. We all know that as a string. All right. Under numeric, once again, under numeric you have integer and real. Under character you have character and string, that is single character constants or multiple character constants. Okay. Now let's go to them one by one. Okay. Integer constants. Okay. Integer constants, under integer constants I can have various types, again subtypes. For example, normal decimal integer. Normal decimal integer you are talking about, I write 123. Best example of a normal decimal integer, 0 to 9, the numbers that will be put over there. Okay. Now, as I said, subtypes, have a look at this particular slide. The subtypes are there with example and it's self-explanatory. Nothing great about it, just that we need to be careful while answering the questions. All right. Have a look. Look at the first one, decimal integer, I said 0 to 9, and there might be a plus or minus symbol at the beginning. See, normally, in case it's an integer constant, you will say it's with a minus sign. But normally with a plus sign, I don't need. Plus is something which is, it is for every number, it's a by default, it's a positive number, isn't it? So look at that example, integer y equal to 123. That's the example. Then comes octal integer. What it consists of? Combination of digits from 0 to 7. Remember this. This is very, very important. Remember, if it is an octal integer constant, okay, then it will be 0 through 7 and will always begin with O at the beginning. Okay, example, integer x equal to 123. Got it. Hexadecimal. Hexadecimal constant is preceded by O x or O small x, O capital X or O small x. They may contain alphabets A to F in caps, in small also. Okay. And the explanation tells you that alphabets A to F refers to what? 10 to 15. Got it? And an example over there. Okay. So as I said, these are self-explanatory. Okay. Self-explanatory. Clear with that? Okay. So those are the types of integer constants for you. Now, under numeric constants again, let's look at real. Okay. When you say real, what does that mean? With decimal places? Okay. If I write 10.23. And this is one of the most confusing types of constant. Why? I'll tell you. Very simple. I walk inside a class, we all know, most of the students, they know C language. Okay. Maybe some of them are not that aware, but most of them know it. I write 10.23 on the board. I say, define this. Give a definition of this. I'll tell you 90% times students will fail answering this question. They'll immediately jump up and say, it's a float value. No, I am asking you for a complete definition of this. Am I right? I'm asking for a complete definition. And you just said float. Got it? I need to define. When I need to define, first thing I need to tell is it's a constant. Got it? Then the type, then the category, whatever it is. 10.23 is a double type constant. By default, any fractional value is a double, remember that. Along with this, I can use something like this. I can say 10.23f. Now this is a floating point constant. Alright? Now, that is where this all this confusion happens. When you define it. Alright? So be very careful with the real type and the different real numbers. Got it? Now, I forgot to tell you in case of integer also. Sometimes if I write something like this, 10. Got it? Integer constant. I quickly say it's an integer constant. Alright? But if I write 10L, it's a long integer constant. Very simple. Okay. That is why I said, look at the number properly, look at the value properly, then try and decide what type or what kind it is. Alright? Now, have a look at this particular slide, which will give you some examples of real constants. Have a look. Look at the first one. Float x equal to 6.3. And why I have deliberately put them as float, because the moment I say float x, it's a float type variable, mind it. But 6.3 is a double constant, and that is the reason I have put it over there. Okay, now look at the second one, 6.3 f, float constant, floating point constant. Then comes z. E plus 2, what this E plus 2 indicates, it has a exponential value, exponents. Later on we'll discuss this in programs, don't worry about that. Now look at the last one, 6.3L, long double constant. Got it? It's a long double constant. Clear with that? Alright, with this particular examples which you saw just now about real type values. Now let's jump into the other side, that is character, the other category. Under primary constants, characters, it can be single character constants. Okay, it can be backslash character constants, something which we had not written over in that categorization. Deliberately we'd skip that. We can discuss that. It's an easy thing to discuss, but know that. Okay, single character constant, it can be multiple character constants, which are also known as strings, and it can also be a slash character constant. Okay, let's have a look at all these categories. Single character constant, I say this, always enclosed within single quotes, remember that. That is something very, very important. And sometimes you'll find this. You must be wondering, single character constant, I have put AB over there. What happens, it allows you maximum two characters within single quotes. Very simple, it will keep the first one, skip the second one. That simply means the value which will be taken into consideration is A. B will be simply ignored. Alright, if I go for this ABC, then it will give an error. Okay, most of the compilers will not allow this. Clear? Similarly, remember one thing. If I say character constants, internally they are stored as integers, represented as integers. Okay, and here there is a bit of confusion when it comes to size up. If I use, there is an operator size up. Okay, if I use size of ch, assuming ch is a character, okay, ch is a character variable. I say size of ch, it will give me what? 1, because character variables are the size of 1 byte. But if you say this size of a, it's a character constant, no? And what I said just now, I said internally they are represented as integers. What this will give you? This will give you size of an integer on your compiler. If it is a 32-bit compiler or above, it might give you 4 bytes, 8 bytes, etc. If it is a 16-bit compiler, it will tell you 2. Got it? Have a look at this particular slide for the examples of character constants and slash character constants. Look at the first one, char p equal to ok. O will be there and k will be omitted. Second one is easy, 34, 3, 4 will be omitted, okay. E equal to space, blank space will be there. S equal to backslash 45, S will hold the value, what? Blank space, 45, an ASCII character which denotes, 45 is the ASCII value for what? Blank space. Got it? Clear with that? Alright. Now look at the one below, backslash character constants, or we call them, otherwise call them escape sequence. You know, normally you all are used to this. You know, slash n for new line, slash b for backspace, slash a for audible. There is a table. Look through internet, you will find that table. It's easy to follow. You know, slash a, audible b. Okay, these are special escape sequences, okay, and your compiler knows them. Clear with that? Alright? Okay, so those are the character constants, and when it is multiple characters, we call them a string. String is what? A sequence of characters, or can be a combination of characters, numbers, symbols, you know, so many things, you can put them together. That also can be a part of the string. You know, like I'll say something like this. If I say hello, it's a string. This will be enclosed within double quotes. 1, 2, 3, it's a string. Even if I write A within double quotes, single A, it becomes a string. Got it? Something very important. All right. I can also have something like this. 1, 2, 3, at the rate, ABC. This is also a string. Remember, easy to follow. Alright. And strings can be single word, can be multi words, multiple words. A string can have a single word, it can have multiple words also. Clear with that? Alright. Have a look at this particular slide for some examples of a string. Single word string, world is here. Having numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. Multi-word string, all is well. Got it? So these are string constants. Clear? Some examples. So here we talked about, you know, constants, and we categorize them into primary and secondary. And in this particular session, we talked about only primary type constants. Got it? Secondary we will put up in the next session. Constants, I have divided it into two different parts, since it's a bit more in that second part, that's the reason. And also that in the second part, when I cover the second part, I'll give you some examples, some questions. Now let's do this. From now on, with every session, we'll try to discuss 3 or 4 questions, maybe multiple choice questions, maybe theory questions related to interviews. You know, this particular session which we are doing, or any session for that matter, what kind of possible questions I might face. Although I'll be doing it separately for you all, but still then. Okay? With every session, at least 2 questions we can pick up and say, okay, these are the questions which might be asked in an interview, and we might cover it. Alright? So friends, that's it for this part. Till the time, take care. Bye-bye.